Steve Addazio enters his second year at Colorado State and brings a new style of offense to the Rams. Rather than trying to light up the scoreboard, Addazio brings a more old-school run the ball down your throat type of approach. Will that translate to success this year? Let's talk about that. We are now only 26 days away from the start of the college football season, meaning we are in prime preview season for college football. Throughout the months of July and August, I will be previewing every college football program, yes, all 130, and in this episode, I will be covering Colorado State. Last year, Colorado State went 1-3, but had 4 of their 8 games canceled due to the global health crisis. This year, they returned 62% of their production from last year, which ranks 88th nationally. On offense, they returned 60% of their production, which ranks 86th, and on defense, they returned 64% of their production, which ranks 83rd. Steve Addazio enters his second year as the head coach of Colorado State and has an overall record of 58-58 in 10 years. He previously coached at Temple and Boston College and is his own special teams coach. New offensive coordinator John Budmeyer spent 6 seasons as an assistant coach with the Wisconsin Badgers and spent the last 3 years as Wisconsin's quarterback coach. Chuck Heater enters his second year as the defensive coordinator for Colorado State. He has prior experience working with Addazio, serving as the Temple defensive coordinator from 2011 to 2012. He spent the 2019 season as an assistant coach for Florida. On offense, they returned 9 starters and moved to a more old-school run-happy offense. At quarterback, they lose Patrick O'Brien to Washington, but will have Temple graduate transfer Todd Senio back, who started the opener last year after O'Brien missed time in camp. Senio dealt with a foot injury last year, but has 27 career games, going 62 for 107 for 820 yards, 8 touchdowns, and 2 interceptions. Addazio compared his leadership skills to Tim Tebow, and the new offensive coordinator said he reminds him of Russell Wilson in college. They also had a trio of true freshmen and redshirt freshman Jonah O'Brien. At running back, Addazio prefers a bell cow running back and added Boston College transfer David Bailey. Bailey had 503 yards and 7 touchdowns last year at Boston College. They also have converted wide receiver Ajon Vivens, who led the team in rushing last year with 210 yards and 1 touchdown. Marcus Ellery had 110 yards and 3 touchdowns last year and is the most experienced running back on the roster. The unit returns intact from last year and should be impressive to watch. When it comes to the receivers, tight end Trey McBride led the team in receiving with 330 yards and 4 touchdowns last year and could be a future NFL tight end. They have speedy wide receiver Dante Wright return, who had 315 yards last year. Tight end Cameron Butler, who missed last year, returns as they utilize a 2 tight end approach a lot of the times. The wide receiver depth is a mystery this year for the Colorado State Rams, though. On the offensive line, they struggled to build cohesion early on last year due to the COVID protocol, but had 124 rushing yards per game, but gave up 12 sacks. This year, they have 91 career starts return and should take a large step forward as well. On defense, they returned 9 starters. On the defensive line, they held opponents to 109 rushing yards per game last year and recorded 16 sacks, 4 sacks a game, and averaged a sack 13.1% of dropbacks on quarterbacks. Miami transfer Scott Patchen led the way with 5.5 sacks and was first team Mountain West. They returned 5 defensive linemen with starting experience. Defensive line coach Antonio Smith believes he has one of the best units in the country. At linebacker, second team Mountain West linebacker Daquan Jackson led the team in tackles with 40 and 5.5 tackles for a loss. Cameron Carter finished with 32 tackles and 4.5 tackles for a loss. Young players got meaningful reps last year, and their top 8 linebackers returned this year. When it comes to the secondary, they improved throughout the season last year. They returned starting experience at all 4 spots and had Temple transfer Linwood Cramp, who had 23 starts. They only lose safety Quinn Brennan and will have a more veteran secondary that will benefit from the strong front 7. They have elite punter Ryan Stonehouse, who returns. According to Phil Steele, they play the 67th toughest schedule, as Athlon projects them to go 4-8 and 3-5, and ESPN projects them to go 5-7. I believe they will go 4-8 and 2-6 in conference, beating South Dakota State and Vanderbilt in the first 2 weeks of the season, before losing to Toledo and Iowa going into their bye, and to San Jose State in their Mountain West Conference opener. Then I believe they win at New Mexico before losing at Utah State, and at home against Boise State, who will be coming off their bye, before losing at Wyoming. Then I believe they beat Air Force before losing their last two games of the season at Hawaii and home against Nevada. But what do you think? How will Colorado State do this season? Make sure to let me know in the comments section below. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, check out my other videos in the preview series. Don't forget to leave a like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And as always, remember to embrace the grind.